ask that you think about something for a moment. What does it mean for you to be spiritual? Or maybe a better way is, what does it mean for you to be a spiritual person or a spiritual being? What part of spirituality is important in your life? I think it's worth considering these questions because people have tried to answer these questions in different ways. For instance, some people believe that we're spiritual beings having human experiences. That's an idea that Pierre Teilhard de Chardin, a French philosopher, suggested. But then there's the perspective that who we are, who our essence is a spiritual being. And that the world around us, it's ephemeral, or maybe it's an illusion, but what's really real is our spirit, our soul. That's taken from some Eastern philosophy. But in the West, a more prominent idea is that the spiritual part of us, our soul, is the real part. That's the most important part. And that our body and our mind and emotions and everything else, that's just passing away, that's a cage holding us together, that it's just something that contains us that passes. All of these thoughts have different implications for us. I want to talk about how we understand ourselves as being people with spirituality and why that's important. And as I do, I want to invite you to subscribe to this channel as well as to click the bell so you're notified of future videos. So I'm going to start with my second question first. Why is it important to talk about these things? Well, again, think about this for a moment. If we believe that we're really spiritual beings having human experiences, or that our essence is a soul or a spirit, and that our body is just a shell that passes, or that the world is an illusion, what does that say about who we are? It says that what's most important about us is that spiritual part, that soul, that spirit. And the rest of it doesn't matter a whole lot. So if the rest of me doesn't matter a whole lot, if my body doesn't matter, if my mind doesn't matter, if my emotions don't matter, if my culture doesn't matter, then we can just toss those aside. And if it doesn't matter for me, then your body and your mind and your emotions, they don't matter. And well, the whole world really doesn't matter. And that's really problematic. And it's that way of thinking that's led to a lot of destruction on our planet, because we've had this view that what's most important is spirit. And so there have been witches killed and wars fought on the basis that if we kill somebody, it really doesn't matter. God will sort it out in the end because, you know, the soul is the thing that's most important. And that's horrific. That doesn't make sense at all. So instead of those various perspectives that I began talking about, I want to invite you to think about who we are in a different way. And why I think that's important is that many people who talk about spirituality promulgate those other perspectives, implicitly that the soul or the spirit is the most important part of who we are. So I want you to think about this. If somebody meets me, or if you're seeing me on a video, what does somebody see? What does somebody meet? They meet me, but they meet my body. You see my body. That's your first encounter with me. That's how you get to know me. And if you talk with me a little bit, you're going to find out about how I think. You may pick up on my emotions, my sense of humor, different aspects of me. If you get to know me better, like people who are my friends or who spend more time with me, You maybe will learn more about my outlook on life, my cultural identity, and find different ways that spirituality works through all of that. But you're meeting a whole person. Just as if I met you, I'd be meeting a whole person. The most important part of me isn't just my spirituality. It's one part of me. It's one dimension. It's one aspect. But there are lots of other aspects that make up who Lou Kavar is. And if you take any of them away, I'm not the same person. And I think that's really important for us to understand. Another example of that is just think about waking up one morning and not feeling very well. It doesn't have to be a major illness. You're just not feeling well. Maybe you're having a reaction to the seasonal pollen, seasonal allergies. And you wake up and your head is really stuffy. It's difficult to breathe. You open your eyes and it's like it's a little bit surreal or a little bit blurry. You're getting out of bed and it's, you know, the room feels like it's shifting on you. And as you start getting ready for your day, you're really irritable because your sinuses are stuffed and you're just not feeling well. And if you try to pray or meditate, it takes a lot of effort. And everything is off kilter because your sinuses are bothering you. It's not just that your body is sick. All of you is sick. We've had this experience. We know this to be true. All of us works together as one. We are an integrated whole. That's who we are as people. And when you take any part of that away, we're not the same people. And if one part isn't working well, the rest of us has to compensate for that or isn't working as well. This same example can work in reverse. The experience of pleasure or joy, it isn't just feeling it in one place, but it radiates through us and gives us a greater sense of life. That's how we are. Some people talk about body-mind-spirit integration. That's one way to look at it. But I think that body-mind-spirit misses the complexity of who we are. It simplifies it a little too much because there are many different aspects and dimensions of who we are, but they're all important. Part of our challenge in life is learning to really live in that integration, in that wholeness, and it's not always easy. Think about this. Consider going for a walk. Only you have a shoe on the right foot and no shoe on the left foot. How are you going to walk? Well, you're going to walk, you know, sort of lopsided. You're going to be shuffling around, stumbling around. You'll walk, you'll make progress, but it's going to look funny, it's going to feel funny, and after a while, it's probably going to hurt. That's because you're off balance. That's because you're not properly integrated for walking. And that's how it is for us. Our growth as individuals, spiritually, physically, emotionally, is about integration, all aspects working together. And that means that at the root of it all, self-knowledge becomes very important. Really getting to know who we are and how we respond. That often takes a lifetime. That's part of our life process, our life journey. And it's a wonderful thing because we keep learning and exploring more and more about ourselves. But remember, we are whole people. Every part of us is important. And as we affirm all those different pieces of us, we grow more fully as the people we were designed to be. Be sure to subscribe to this channel, like the video, share it with others, leave me some comments and questions, and know that I really appreciate the time you spend with Spirituality Beyond Borders. Have a really great day. Thank you.